Hey, Mariana.
Hello.
I'm looking for...
She's not here, Wendell.
If you'll just let me finish, Mariana, if you could just let me finish what I was going to say. I'm looking for Doreen.
She's not here.
I'm looking for her because I love her, and I want to tell her right now.
Okay, well, she's still not here because she doesn't work here anymore. And to be honest, she's over you.
Look, Mariana, I know you and I never really hit it off, and at times you might not have even liked me all that much.
I don't.
Jesus.
Wow.
Did she get my letter?
It was a postcard.
Don't be a wise ass, honey. Nobody likes them, trust me. And I don't expect you to understand, Mariana. I don't, because you've never, ever had somebody feel about you the way that I do about Doreen, so I'd appreciate...
Wait in the car, big guy. I think we got off on the wrong foot. We just need to know where Doreen's working now.
Thank you.
Or at least her phone number.
Yeah, well, I'm not exactly authorized to tell you that, whoever the hell you are.
Is there anything you're authorized to do?
Besides not know a goddamn thing?
Yeah. Rolodex. Jesus.
I only knew that some mornings when I woke up, there was evidence of a very strange night, and I was exhausted. So I did some research. I'm a textbook expert now. Scientists versus psychiatrists. Everybody's got a different theory. Post-traumatic stress, the lack of atonia.
Muscle paralysis is what prevents you from running or jumping while you're dreaming.
Yeah, that gizmo seems to malfunction in my body.
Why didn't you get help?
Because in medicine, the answer to every unknown is insanity. So I just became very skilled at hiding my night adventures. He knows better than to be messing around here. Everyone around here knows that poor, sweet boy. He's no harm. He always keeps to himself. Skin disease. He was just a little boy when it started. Didn't you look at his face? I'm tired of being a two-faced person.
You're not two-faced.
Yeah, I am. I mean, just 2 weeks ago, I was telling him I love you. Every morning when we wake up, I tell him I love you. I love you. Because he needed to hear it. And so I would just say, I didn't mean it. Kind of like you're saying it to me right now. Even though you don't mean it. But I don't need you to say it to me if you don't mean it. I don't want you to say it if it's a lie.
It's not a fucking lie. I've been in love with you since I met you. Okay, I mean it.
You tell me how it happened?
was someplace I shouldn't have been. This old place called the Clunk Music Hall, and it had this old jukebox that I just really loved, and I used to play it all night.
So where you met Len?
He bought me a drink. Bought me several drinks. And then when I started feeling dizzy, he said he would drive me home. Just thought he was being a gentleman. But then he pulled down this gravel road and he raped me. And he just kicked me out of the car when he was done. Left me there. And I just laid there. I just wanted to die. But I didn't. So I just got up and walked home. No. Baby, listen. I only ever prayed 2 times in my life. Once. To not feel so all alone. And once. For Rosalind to be punished for what he did. Baby, you were the answer to both my prayers.